I'm in the George Washington National Forest near Strasburg, Virginia. This is the Massanutten mountain range, the very northern end of it. And this area here is called the Elizabeth Furnace Recreation Area. It's off Fort Valley Road. When you first come in off of Fort Valley Road, it's right up there. When you first come down here, there's this nice parking area here. There's my little red car. And we are going to go up into those mountains there, which is the western section of the Massanutten. The Massanutten mountain range is splits into two pieces, and one set of the ridge lines over there, and the other one's over this on this side. And the further south you go, the further apart they get. So we're going to start here. We're going to go down this way, cross over Passage Creek, and look for the White Blaze Trail. Okay, after wandering around for like a mile and checking out a couple of different trails, I finally found the trailhead for the White Blaze Trail. You've got to cross over Passage Creek and continue to follow the parking signs until you get to this great big parking area right here. There's a parking area here, and down at that end, over that way, there's a couple of bathrooms. And then down here at this end is this thing, this sign area, and if you notice, it's got a white blaze on it. So this is the beginning of the White Trail. I'm going to reset my GPS, and we'll finally get started on the hike I was planning to take. Tenth of a mile into my hike, I'm on the White Blaze Trail, and there's Passage Creek, and I am going to turn left here and follow these signs that say Sherman Gap, and we're going to head up into the mountains up there. Still here, getting ready to leave the Passage Creek and head up into the mountains. I decided to go ahead and calibrate my altimeter, since I hadn't done it probably since last fall sometime. The elevation here is 750 feet, and we're heading up into the mountains up that way, and I think we're going to peak out around 2,000 feet. So here we go. Eight-tenths of a mile into my hike. I've been following Passage Creek upstream the whole ways, and just a very slight increase in elevation. I'm up to 830 feet elevation, and this is the turnoff for the Sherman Gap Trail. It's blazed pink. You can't miss it because the White Trail just ends right here. It's a T-bone. So your only choices from here are go downhill or uphill. So we're going to turn left and head uphill, and from looking at the map, this part of the hike from here to the top looks pretty steep, so come on feet. .2 miles into my hike, I'm up to 1,510 feet elevation. That's looking back where I came from. Down there's the valley, the road it came in on, some farms down there. The Elizabeth Furnace parking area is down that way. And there's a trail I came up on. And from here, it's about another half a mile, pretty much straight up the side of the mountain now. This is going to be the steepest part. The last few tenths of a mile has been pretty steep, but this is going to be the steepest until I get up to the ridge line. I'm going to stop here for a couple minutes and rest and drink some water. .6 miles into my hike, I'm up to 1,975 feet elevation, and I'm up along the ridge line now. And there's a bunch of signs up here. This is where the Sherman Gap Trail turns to the right and heads south. Here's the Sherman Gap Trail coming up from the west. That's looking to the west. That's where I came from. I am going to head this way, which is to the north, and hike to the north back to Shawl Gap. It's about 2 miles back there. That's looking to the east. The mountain range off in the distance is Shenandoah National Park. And between here and there is the one of the forks of the Shenandoah River. And it's a little bit afternoon, so I think I'm going to walk over there and I'll park myself on that blown down tree and eat some lunch. Well, as usual, we've got another super exciting trail meal there. We've got Bumblebee Snack on the Run chicken salad. Got the chicken salad in a little can, and some crackers to put it on. Nature Valley breakfast biscuits. Those are honey flavored. And the always popular Lance Toast Chee crackers made with real peanut butter. 5 grams of peanut butter goodness. Wash it down with some water. Still sitting up here on the ridge line. I'm sitting on this great big huge blown down tree eating. Just got done eating that exciting trail meal. I didn't eat the peanut butter crackers because I got a better idea. On my way home, maybe I'll go by Front Royal and they got this place called Spelunkers. They have frozen custard. Yum. Man, I'm going to get some of that. It's nice up here today, really, really nice. Maybe about 65 degrees. See how big this tree is? That's looking to the east towards Shenandoah National Park, that mountain range off in the distance. That's what that is. That's the national park over there. I'm going to sit here and drink a little more water and then head that way, which is north, and start working my way back towards my car. It's going to take a while. I'm up on the ridge line, but there's a zoom. I'm zoomed in pretty high right there, but there's the Shenandoah River down there. Looks nice from up here. Into my hike, I'm still hiking the ridgeline. There's the ridgeline right there. I'm just on the west side of it, just slightly down a little ways. That's looking to the north. Since I'm over here on the west side, here's a look to the west. The next range over there is the second part of the Massanutten mountain range. There's some farms down there in the valley. There's where I came from. It's pretty rocky trail. It's hard on your feet. Up there's the ridge. And here's looking to the north again. I think I got about another mile to hike along the ridge here. 5.1 miles into my hike. I'm down to about 1900 feet elevation. And I've got one more peak to climb, which is that one right there. Got to climb that peak and get over on the other side of it, and then I should get to Shawl Gap, and then I can turn left and start heading down the side of the mountain. It's about probably about a half a mile there to the peak. Miles into my hike. I'm at Shawl Gap now. The elevation here is about 1690, and there's a survey benchmark embedded in this rock right here. I can't read the identifier on it, but it looks like the date is 1935. I'll get some pictures of it and look it up in the database when I get home. Anyway, here's what it looks like here at Shawl Gap. That's looking to the north. That's looking to the east. Over there is an old trace of the road that went down the east side of the mountain. Up there is, that's from the south, that's where I came from. And that way is to the west. I gotta find the trail here that heads down back towards my car. So I'm gonna sit here for a minute and rest, and then find the trail that takes me back down to my car. Okay, here's Shawl's Gap, where all the trails come together. There's the white trail heading to the north. A yellow blaze trail heads down the east side of the mountain that way. The blue and orange trails both head south in that direction. That's where I came from. And here's where the blue and orange trails make a left and head down the west side of the mountain. I'm going this way. I'll stay on the blue trail. If I find the yellow blaze trail, which is the old trail, I may take that because that's a more direct route back down to my car. But I'll either stay on the blue, or if I can find the yellow, I'll pick up the yellow. And this is 6 miles into my hike, and the elevation here is 1,700 feet. Miles into my hike, I'm down to 1,500 feet, and this is what the I just turned off onto the old yellow trail, which is an old wagon road. It's unbelievably steep though, but I'm gonna go ahead and walk on the wild side and go down this yellow trail. This is a map of today's hike. The quadrangle name is Strasburg 1994. You come in on Fort Valley Road. This is in between Front Royal and Strasburg. Front Royal is over this way to the east, and Strasburg is over this way to the west. But you come down Fort Valley Road until you get to right here, and you'll see a turnoff for the Elizabeth Furnace Recreation Area. The Elizabeth Furnace ruins are the ruins of an old pig iron furnace. And those are there, and you can take a look at them. They're over here. But anyway, I parked the big picnic area was closed off, so you couldn't come across the bridge here, across Passage Creek. So there's a smaller parking area right here, just off the road, that's always open. So I parked here. And what I found out the hard way is the trailhead for some of the trails starts as soon as you get across the bridge. But for this white blaze trail that I used, you have to follow the road up this way until you get to the main parking area here. Now, at the south end, down here at this end of the main parking area, there is a information sign, and it's got a big white blaze on it, and it's the trailhead for the white blazed trail. So you start the hike here, and you hike south along Passage Creek until you, and this is fairly flat, until you get to here. Now when you get to here, you make a left-hand turn on this Sherman Gap Trail. It's blazed pink. And starting here, you start to climb the mountain. It's not real steep, though, but you are climbing, okay, for a couple of miles. And then there's a switch back here. And then starting here, it is really, really steep. From here, as you can, if you look at the contour lines, you'll see that you're basically just going straight up the side of the mountain until you get up here. Now this is the ridge line up here, and then you turn left and you follow along this ridge line. Now starting here along this ridge line, this is There's some up and down hiking, but it's fairly flat, but it is kind of difficult hiking because it's very rocky, which is hard on the bottoms of your feet and it's hard on your ankles and stuff. But anyway, in the middle of the summer, there really aren't going to be any views from up here because of all the trees. I took a few shots with my camera. The leaves have not come out on the trees up here. This is around 2,000 feet. And then eventually, you start to once you get past this point called High Peak, you start to descend down to this saddle area here at Shaw Gap. Now, when you get to Shaw Gap, this is where I found that survey benchmark that I took a picture of. And then from here, what you do is you pick up this blue trail that goes down the west side of the mountain. Now, I followed the blue trail down to about here, and then the blue trail comes way over like this, and then it comes back like that. Okay, and that's the current trail, but the old road, which they call the Yellow Trail, when I got to here, I just veered to the right and just followed the old road. Now, this is not maintained, and it's crazy steep. I tried to get a couple of pictures of it. It's the old wagon road that they used to carry the pig iron after it was refined in these furnaces into ingots. They put it in wagons, and somehow or other, with horses or mules or whatever, they managed to cart that pig iron up and over the mountain here at Shaw Gap. And if you see this dotted line down here the other way, to points to the east. But it's just unbelievably steep. It's hard to imagine them hauling that stuff up this road. But anyway, this road is not maintained, but it's easy to stay on it. There's a lot of trees blown. When you get down about here, there's a lot of trees blown down and things that you'll have to climb over. But it takes you right on back to the picnic area, and then you just go back across the bridge back to the car. I haven't looked at my GPS yet, but I don't know, it's probably 6 or 7 miles. I would say from here up to the top, this is pretty strenuous right here. In terms of just, I think from here up to here, I must have stopped to rest 3 or 4 times, because it's just straight up the side of the mountain. Nice hike. If you live in the Washington metro area, it's fairly easy to get to from Interstate 66 or Interstate 81, depending on where you're coming from. And it was a nice day today, so I was glad to be able to get out and do that hike.